State investigators concealed degree of Aaron Hernandez's drug use prior to suicide. State investigators had more evidence than previously disclosed that former New England Patriots star Aaron Hernandez was using a dangerous drug in prison prior to his death, information that was concealed in public records and from his family and lawyers. An inmate interview with officials the day Hernandez died, April 19, 2017, was partially redacted from a 132-page public report. The hidden portion, which the Globe was able to review last week for the first time, said, he spent the last 2 days smoking K2 in his cell and he wasn't in the right frame of mind. This new disclosure is significant because it could shed more light on why the 27-year-old convicted murderer took his own life. It also raises questions about whether state officials sought to hide the extensive use of contraband drugs by inmates, including by one of their most well-known prisoners, and its potential influence on his death. Any disturbing commentary about the state's investigation was clearly hidden from the public, Aaron's lawyers, and his family, said George Leon Tyre, a lawyer for Hernandez, as well as for his fiancée and young daughter. Department of Corrections spokesman Jason Dobson said the inmate's interview was blacked out because a separate investigation was ongoing into suspected drug activity at the prison. The section was redacted so as not to compromise that investigation. Hernandez's suicide took his family and lawyers by surprise. Only 5 days earlier, he had been acquitted of a 2012 double murder in Boston's South End despite substantial evidence he was involved and at the scene. As a result, he had sounded optimistic about his chances of overturning his life sentence for the 2013 killing of Odin Lloyd. Inmates interviewed by prison officials at the Sousa Baranowski Correctional Center the day Hernandez was found hanged in his cell said he had been upbeat and talking about spending time with his daughter and fiancé. One inmate said, "What do you do when you get good news?" adding, "You celebrate, right?" It turns out that same inmate, however, said more than that to prison investigators, according to the newly revealed interview. The unnamed inmate who talked about Hernandez's K2 use also said, that SH is expletive all these young kids up and they aren't going to stop no matter what happens in here. K2 is often called synthetic marijuana, but it's far more toxic than pot. It comes as liquid or in the form of plant matter sprayed with an ever-changing array of chemicals that can cause hallucinations and other effects. It's popular with prisoners because it's difficult to detect in routine drug tests and has been easy to smuggle in. Dobson said Department of Correction officials fully disclosed all information known to the state police detective unit investigating Hernandez's death for the Worcester County District Attorney's Office. But there still seemed to be a disconnect between what investigators knew and how they portrayed Hernandez's death to the public. After Hernandez's death, an autopsy was performed by the chief medical examiner. Toxicology tests were performed by an outside laboratory, NMS Labs of Willow Grove, PA. On May 4, 2017, 2 weeks after Hernandez's death, the state police issued a report stating that a post-mortem toxicology of Hernandez's blood came back negative for all substances tested to include synthetic cannabinoids, and asked for the case to be closed. Felix Brown, spokesman for the state's Executive Office of Public Safety and Security, would not comment on how thorough the toxicology tests were, saying the medical examiner does not release case-specific details to the public. Past media reports, citing unnamed sources, have suggested Hernandez used drugs before his suicide. A Newsweek story, for example, said traces of the drug K2 were found after his death. But documents detailing his alleged K2 use have not been made public until now. Records recently reported on by the Globe Spotlight team, coupled with the newly disclosed inmate interview, show that immediately after Hernandez's death, officials had at least 2 tips that he had been using drugs. As reported in the Spotlight series, another inmate was able to sneak into Hernandez's cell and allegedly smoked K2 with him 2 days before his death.
MW News, please subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.